On February 15th, 2015, a day after the death of Michele Ferrero, Italy's richest man and founder of one of the most dominant companies in the global confectionery market, the Italian journalist Mario Calabresi, then director of the Turin-based newspaper La Stampa, finally published a conversation with him. He had recorded the chat 5 years earlier and had jealously kept it a secret until the entrepreneur's death. Michele Ferrero was a man of great faith and discretion. He would rather talk with his action or products and had never released any interviews. So Calabresi's piece truly gave an unprecedented peek at his life. Il mio segreto? Fare sempre diverso dagli altri. Avere fede, tenere duro e mettere ogni giorno al centro la Valeria. My secret? Ferrero revealed, to always do things differently than others, to always have faith and hold on, and to always put Valeria at the center of my daily work. Who is Valeria? You might ask with Calabresi. Here is Ferrero again. Valeria is the boss, the CEO, the one who decides about your success or your end, the one whom you should respect, whom you should never betray, but always understand. Valeria is the mom who goes grocery shopping, the grandma, the aunt. She is the consumer who decides what to buy every day. She is the one who decides that Walmart is the biggest store in the world. If one day she changes her mind and no longer buys from you, then you are doomed. You are done without notice, because she doesn't send you a letter from her lawyer notifying you about the termination of a contract. She's just simply decided to go somewhere else, to stop buying from you. Valeria is sacred. You should study her with attention and never improvise. And I end my quote here. It's in dialogue with Valeria that all of Ferrero's innovations came about. It's in the context of his family that his company grew sustainably and without frenzy into a global holding. It's because of his faith, or in his words, thanks to the intercession of Mary, that he found the strength to build one of the most interesting industrial realities in Italy and in the world. It all started in his Piedmont hometown of Alba, where his parents owned a pastry shop. Alba is the main city of the Langhe area, in between Turin and Genoa. If you like red wine, the Langhe are the hills of Nebbiolo, Barbera, Barolo, and Barbaresco. And if you like white truffle, well, Alba is your place. Now, before becoming one of Italy's most attractive destinations for food and agricultural tourism, the Langhe were actually a very poor territory. In 1944 and 1945, it was the theater of Italy's war of resistance. And after World War II, it was just a desolate land, whose only wealth came from the cultivation of hazelnuts, and whose only glory came from its two phenomenal riders, Cesare Pavese and Beppe Fenoglio. Pavese saw it as a mystical, almost pagan wasteland, whereas Fenoglio saw in its hills the counterpart of Melville's Dark Ocean in Moby Dick. If you love literature, you should definitely read Fenoglio's A Private Affair, made it into a movie by the Taviani brothers in 2018, or Pavese's The Moon and the Bonfires. Against this backdrop, in the years after World War II, Michele's father Pietro set up a lab to supply his pastry shop, which he eventually turned into a factory. To make up for the scarcity of cocoa, he started to experiment by mixing chocolate with local hazelnuts, an idea that would later lead to the creation of Nutella. Pietro died in 1949, and his brother led the company until 1957, when his son Michele took over. Over the next decades, Michele would aggressively target markets overseas and establish production centers in Europe, North and South America, Southeast Asia, Africa, Australia, and more recently in Turkey, Mexico, and China. At the same time, Michele would tirelessly continue to innovate and create new products like the wildly acclaimed Mon Cheri, Nutella, Kinder Ferrero, Ferrero Rocher, and Tic Tac. If I were to pinpoint here the key of his commercial success, I would place it in his ability to live reality and penetrate its human fabric, anticipating the desires of Valeria first through observation and dialogue, and then through speculation and planning. Here is how he did it. In the early 1950s, he intuited that Germany was his key market. First, because every summer he had to recall chocolate in Italy in order not to disappoint Valeria with a melted product. And second, because the constant consumption of chocolate in Northern Europe could guarantee him a uniform turnover throughout the year. Post-war Germany, however, was then a country in disarray, and Italians there were negatively viewed as cowards and traitors. As a way to warm both bodies and hearts, Ferrero then had the idea of mixing chocolate with liquor, of adding a cherry to it, and turning it into a charming gift, luxuriously wrapped in red. The German Valeria, he clarified in his last and only interview, needed to be comforted, to feel good every day, to be rewarded with a little daily gift. It could work for dating couples, husbands and wives, and there was no need to wait for big occasions. And that's how the hugely popular Mon Cheri came about. The story of his later products makes even more manifest Ferrero's ability to relate external circumstances to human needs, as well as his insatiable drive to innovate, starting from the urge to think and do things differently than others. This is how the Nutella spread was born in 1964. While everybody else was producing solid chocolate, Ferrero grew his father's idea of combining hazelnuts and cocoa into a creamy spread and transported it from Alba's lab to the world, as seen in the product's name, Nutella, modeling an Italian-sounding word on the English nut. Needless to say that Nutella is still today the most recognizable global product by Ferrero. Along the same lines is the crazy intuition that led to the creation of Kinder Ferrero in 1968. Focusing on chocolate eggs with a surprise inside, a common Easter treat in Italy, Ferrero was looking for solutions to replicate the joy of the surprise on a smaller scale and bypass the seasonality of the product. Here again are his words. I thought of Mom Valeria, who could reward her child for a good grade at school, or Grandma Valeria, or Aunt Valeria, who could receive a hard-to-earn kiss, hug, or compliment, and I add quote. So, in order not to worry moms, he began producing little surprise eggs with more milk and less cocoa, launching, against all odds, the idea of a chocolate line for kids. Even Michele's wife objected that chocolate eggs could only sell at Easter. To this challenge, Ferrero simply replied, "Well, starting from tomorrow, every day will be Easter." Over the years, the company won a big portion of the global confectionery market by developing new signature products like Ferrero Rocher or Tic Tac, and by acquiring other brands. The Ferrero Group recently started a merger with Olten, the leading company for collecting and trading hazelnuts in Turkey, site of 70% of the world's production. In 2017, the group assimilated the British company Thornton's, and in 2018, it acquired the Nestlé USA's chocolate confectionery business, which includes brands like Butterfinger, Baby Ruth, 100 Gran, Raisinets, and Crunch. I can certainly testify about Nutella and other Ferrero products, but I confess I still need a few more Halloweens to get a full range of these candies and sweets. Now, in this whole story, what fascinates me is also the continuity that Michele Ferrero gave to his company from generation to generation, anchoring his business in his family roots, his territory, and his solid values. In 1987, Ferrero's two sons, Pietro and Giovanni, became co-CEOs of the company. In 2011, however, Pietro unexpectedly died during a bicycle ride in South Africa, and his brother Giovanni, a published novelist, fully assumed the role of chief executive. Quite a story, huh? An author and writer turned into the CEO of a global company. Meanwhile, the company continued to be rooted in Alba, investing in projects for the community and starting the Fondazione Ferrero for the care of elderly people and former workers. In terms of values, the brand's motto, share values to create values, and the triad of verbs defining Ferrero's philosophy, lavorare, creare, donare, or rather, to work, to create, and to give as a gift, are still very much at the core of this industrial enterprise. The success of the group primarily rests indeed on the care for its people and on the creation of an entrepreneurial culture focused on delivering high-quality products and dedicated to the construction of the common good, from commercial outcomes to human and social fruits, so in the support for local communities, the promotion of healthy lifestyles, and the engagement in sustainable agricultural practices. The thousands of people gathered in front of Alba's cathedral for Michele Ferrero's funeral are a testament to the good that his industrial venture generated. I invite you to visit Ferrero's webpage to find the key concepts behind the company, whose commitment to achieving its commercial goals, and I quote here, is not detached from the principles that guide its actions, namely loyalty and trust, respect and responsibility, integrity and moderation, passion for research and innovation, end quote. Ferrero's pursuit of excellence finds its soil in a culture of personal responsibility and initiative, summarized by the company's insistence on learning by doing. Michele Ferrero's whole entrepreneurial philosophy then finds its ultimate summary in the word initiative, as a personal impulse toward initiating something, as an attitude of proactive responsibility for one's vision and investments, and as an endless drive to start processes, maximize results, and pursue human values. Now, here is my Italian summary of today's episode. Michele Ferrero è un innovatore italiano nell'ambito dell'industria del cioccolato. La sua visione e la sua creatività hanno dato origine a prodotti di successo globale, come ad esempio Nutella, e hanno generato un modello industriale e culturale sostenibile su scala globale. That's it for today. Don't forget to try all of the Ferrero products over the next few days, with moderation, but above all, with an awareness of their story. Even though we rarely think of it, every industrial piece is ultimately the fruit of a lot of human desire, commitment, and dedication. Also, don't forget to follow me on Twitter for more updates and contents related to this episode. Thanks for listening. Arrivederci e alla prossima.